Let's move on to the big conversation point here at the 9 p.m. on the urban debate. And as the winter set in, viewers, on the 9 p.m. tonight, frankly, I don't have any new questions, and I'm dreading some of the conversations, maybe the same that we had last year and last to last year and the year before that. But the problem still remains, the problem of pollution. The problem probably is graver now with the added challenge of coronavirus. So not only do the citizens of NCR and the national capital have to deal with pollution, wear masks, stay indoors, think about whether they want to let their children out, struggle with respiratory problems. The respiratory problems themselves will become a bit of a challenge. And the government itself is saying that there may be a rise in COVID cases. So it's a dual challenge. But unfortunately, if I sit and look at what's been happening, I don't see too much of a difference to many steps that have been taken by any of the state governments. So I'm going to ask the same questions. I'm hoping there are some new answers of why we seem to be in the same spot that we are year and year again. Experts have warned of COVID spike in winters. In fact, that's been seen in some other parts of the world. A central government's report said around 50,000 cases per day could be registered in Delhi. So we need to be watchful of that. The government seemed to be very wary of the stubble burning issue. There is already a massive farm protest going on over the central government's legislations. No government now wants to go and stop the farmers and say that don't burn the stubble, you are adding to the pollution problem. None of them have found a long-term constructive solution to the stubble burning problem. In the absence of a strong public transport, as people come out during times of a pandemic, many are preferring to now go in cars. More and more cars are on the road. That adds to the whole problem. Several of the thermal plants in and around Delhi, especially around Delhi, are still continue to function, adding to Delhi's pollution. I'm also going to talk to you about how the stubble burning has significantly gone up this year, and especially from the state of Punjab. And citizens of Delhi at some point will have to struggle. But let me put one statistic, one piece of information in front of you as we go into this conversation. It's not just us, it's not just the people of Delhi who are fed up with this problem. So are the courts. I mean, what to say when the highest court of the country has repeatedly looked into the issue of pollution, repeatedly passed orders, even gone to the extent of saying we're going to start jailing officials who don't do their job, and still things don't change on ground. Between 2015 to 2019, as per the EPCA website, there have been 128 different Supreme Court orders on the issue of pollution. 128. Think about that. Let's say good evening to the panelists who are joining us this evening on this conversation. I've got Mr. Harish Khurana of the BJP who's with me on this conversation. We've also got Captain Shalini Singh joining us this evening. Mr. Harshvardhan Puri, Sanjay Upadhyay, and Mr. Abhishek Dutt also with us this evening. So let's straight away get to the conversation. And I want to begin with the experts. So I actually want to begin with Dr. Harshvardhan Puri, who's a public health expert and a consultant thoracic surgeon at Sri Gangaram Hospital. Dr. Puri, just help our viewers also understand why this winter season could be a dual challenge for Delhi.
Am I audible? Hello.
Yes, Dr. Puri, I can hear you now. Go ahead, please.
Actually, this is a dual challenge. Good evening, everyone. This is a dual challenge because we face two major problems this winter. One is the pollution, which we are talking from the last, I guess, 5 years, 6 years. It has been there. It's increasing. And the other thing is COVID-19, the contact which we are dealing with. Now, how this thing is, I just want to take 2 minutes of yours. One is that wherever the PM5 level is higher, it's around 190, 200. Like today morning in Delhi, it was 170, which is in red zone. So what happens is this contagion. This TM2.5 act as an to this contagion, and the spread is larger. We all know that studies have now proven that it is an airborne disease. So the spread of this will be higher in the areas where the pure PM2.5 level is higher. This is one point. So the places which are more polluted will have higher, larger spread of COVID-19. One problem is that. The other problem which we'll be facing is that there are many studies now which are coming from Italy, from US, from China, that the more polluted city is, more the number of deaths are due to COVID-19. It takes no Einstein brain to think COVID-19 acts on the respiratory system of a human being. And if the lungs are already compromised because of the air pollution, then we are going to have more problems in that particular individual because of COVID-19. So there is a direct cause and effect relationship. Because of pollution, the COVID-19 cases will increase and the mortality rate will definitely increase in winters. Thank you.
Okay, and if I can just also bring in Mr. Sanjay Upadhyay, Advocate Supreme Court and Managing Partner for Enviro Legal Defense Firm. Mr. Upadhyay, like I said at the beginning of this conversation, it's really unfortunate that the top court has had to pass 128 orders in the last 4 years, and still we are having the same conversations and the problem of pollution doesn't seem to go away. Why is that?
Well, I think prior to the 128 orders, you have to also look at the National Green Tribunal, which has been dealing with this for almost 5 years now. And I think one of the problems is a lack of judicial continuity, in my understanding. What happens is, as a lawyer, you'll experience that many, many judgments or many orders don't feed into each other. So there are judges who come and there are petitioners who come who raise their issue, and then they go when there's a particular order, and then you're expected to implement that particular order. Now, there are as many as 20 to 22 very concrete steps in the last 5 years, let's say from the National Green Tribunal or from the Honorable Supreme Court, which hasn't seen the light of the day. I wouldn't say everything, but a substantial portion which hasn't really seen the light because of a coordinated effort that is missing. So one of the things that I, as a lawyer, would suggest is if you keep having only ad hoc orders, you're not going to get to a very definitive point. And one of the things that I keep talking about is to look at the Air Pollution Act itself. I mean, it's a 1981 vintage, and we haven't really looked at the legal frame that everybody understands. These are not, you know, when you say 128 orders, I don't know how many people are even aware of 8 of those 128 orders, or when NGT has come out with at least 7-8 judgments in about 8-9 different cases, who's really actually, you know, looking at a coordinated understanding of what it means on the ground? Because at the end of the day, the regulators are the same. You have to depend on the district magistrate or the same police official for implementation along with the Pollution Control Board. Now, nobody's talking about their capacity and their priority as far as air pollution is concerned. And whenever we have the season, everybody's talking about it like we are. So I think there's a huge necessity to look into what is the institutional mechanism we have to ensure this delivery of the orders and the wisdom of the courts and people who've approached the courts. I think that's where the problem is. We need to tackle that.
Okay, ad hoc orders perhaps are not the best way to go forward. I do agree with you, and I think and this is just my personal view, that maybe the court now needs to stop giving warnings and pulling up governments or wrapping the governments or threatening to jail officials. Maybe it's just time to send some of the officials and government members accountable for this behind bars. There needs to be accountability fixed. Because if our governments won't do their job year after year and the citizens continue to suffer to the extent that people have now begun to consider moving out of these places, then perhaps we have to turn to the judiciary and seek or request for stepping in with stricter implementation. Maybe that's the only way forward. But let me go across to Abhishek Dutt, National Spokesperson for the Congress Party. Mr. Dutt, I am looking at data just about stubble burning in Punjab. and the numbers are staggering. Instead of the numbers going down from 2018 to 2019 to 2020, the numbers seem to have gone up. It's as if instead of stopping the farmers and enabling them with alternate solutions, you're actually just giving them a free hand to pollute the environment.
Tanvi, first of all, when you've started the debate, I think there is no time left for warning. Now the courts have to take action. For the last 4 years, we've been debating this every season. This is what we speak every time about air pollution. And after 10 days, everyone forgets about it. I will tell you, the Honorable Prime Minister of our country last year had set up a committee called Pragati, which was proactive governance and timely implementation, where he had specifically directed the agriculture minister to provide all the machineries to Punjab and Haryana to control stubble farming. But the problem is, the moment this season gets over, the moment this 20 days of air pollution gets over, everyone forgets about it. Where Punjab is concerned, the amount of customer care centers Punjab has set up, there are about 7,300 approximately customer care centers. Till now, 53,000 fields have been serviced. But the problem about Delhi is not only related to stubble burning in Punjab or Haryana. There are bigger problems in Delhi. If you look at the transportation system in Delhi, if you look at the dust factory in Delhi, if you look at the waste segregation in Delhi, and I'll talk about the article which appeared in Times of India last week, which talks about we've started shifting trees, which is failed as a phenomena. So, you know, it is not only about one stubble burning. There are a lot of composite factors around which, because of which Delhi is suffering. If you remember during the coronavirus time, during that whole lockdown period, Yamuna was absolutely clean. There was no air pollution in Delhi. But all of a sudden, as Delhi has exposed itself, Delhi has opened itself, again, we are back to square one. Yes, stubble burning is one of the factors. But that is not the only factor for air pollution in Delhi. There are much bigger factors. And I think the central government, the way they've imposed these Farmers Act on all the states, they have to come out with a policy which is very strong, which is funded by the central government to stop this. At the same time, Delhi government has to play its role where controlling pollution in Delhi is concerned. They have to buy buses. If you look at the transportation system in buses,
you know, Mr. Dutt, in your entire answer, I haven't heard a single sentence so far of taking up some responsibility as the Punjab government. Either it's the center's fault or it's the Delhi government's fault.
Absolutely
not. Can you really
not
absolve yourself from any responsibility? It's not an overnight decision. It's not to say that the Punjab government doesn't have funds. The Punjab government claims to stand with the farmers at every single issue. How is it that we've not figured out and brought in the machinery? We can't simply say the center hasn't given us money for anything, so we are not going to do this by ourselves. How many cases has there been an action beyond an FIR? I mean, look at the numbers. All of that smoke which is going in air, whether or not it reaches Delhi is not the point. It's harmful for the environment.
Tanvi, if I remind you of the letter that the Honorable Chief Minister of Punjab wrote to the Prime Minister last year, and if you go by the letter in spirit, he has actually the same concerns like you and us. But you must realize, Punjab Chief Minister independently or Haryana Chief Minister, Haryana is run by Bharatiya Janata Party. But these two chief ministers independently cannot fight it. It has to be a central government movement where they have to support these states. Where machinery is concerned, all these states have got limited income. Even I'm not criticizing Haryana as well. I'm talking about the central government has to play that role. If you go by the article 2 years back, the central government was supposed to fund these governments with providing machineries. How many machineries independently Punjab government can fight? I told you there are 7,300 customer care numbers. If you look at the letter that Amrinder Singh ji has written to EPCA, he very clearly mentions the intentions of the Punjab government. He talks about putting up plants, he talks about biogas, he talks about everything that will stop air pollution. But at the end of the day, the central government has
so
to...
So, Harish Khurana, the Congress party is saying that all that the Punjab government can do at this point is make a plan and write a letter. Everything else is not in their control. It's actually in the control of the BJP and the central government. Give them the money. Give the money, please, to Haryana and Punjab so this problem can be sorted. Harish Khurana, can you hear me? Okay, we're going to fix that line with him and come back to him on that issue. But let me bring in Captain Shalini Singh. Captain Shalini Singh, I am looking at this one report that has been put out by the Council on Energy, Environment and Water. And it actually says that the factors contributing to Delhi pollution also includes transport, which is 18% to 39%. Road dust contributes 18% to 38%. Industries contribute 20% to 29%, basis what time you're looking at. So it's not just the crop burning issue. Now, please tell me, what is it the Delhi government has managed to do in the last 1 year?
Good evening, everyone. So first of all, I would like to say that it's very important that we understand that clean air is a fundamental right of every citizen. It is not about Delhi or Punjab or Haryana. As Dr. Harshvardhan rightly brought out, that it is affecting our entire body. Our liver, kidney, we are getting affected. Asthma, a lot of ailments are happening to people. Delhi government has been round the clock putting in continuous efforts to bring in clean air, trying to reduce pollution day in and day out. Always claiming that it is on the stubble burning. Stubble burning has not started since just 3-4 years back. It's been a long process that it is happening. Very important to understand that Delhi government has been putting in continuous efforts. They have the first, I would say, by giving electricity 24/7. DG sets have been removed. Heavy fines have been imposed in construction sites violation. Drastic reduction in traffic entering Delhi. Two thermal power plants have been closed. There has been ban on garbage burning, dumping. I'm just telling you a few things which Delhi government has been doing, and still we are not satisfied. We are not saying we are doing a commendable work, and we are still putting in a lot of effort. But with our little effort, we have brought down pollution in some way. Now it has to be a combined effort. Now central government can't say that we can't do it alone in isolation. It has to be a requirement that all governments, whether it is Punjab government, Haryana government, central government, Delhi government, everybody should come together and provide the fundamental right of every citizen of breathing in clean air, not dying because of pollution. It is not about between the governments that it is my...
Delhi. So tell me this, Captain Shalini. Firstly, I am looking at some of the data as well. Public transport promises that were made of ramping up, not yet achieved, initiated, not achieved. Garbage segregation and management, not done. Greening and pavement of roads, target, not achieved. Electric buses for public transport, not happened yet. These are some of the things that you had asked. Yes, you have shut down a couple of thermal power plants in the city. But tell me the steps that have been specifically taken and these promises where you have failed, where you've not done this. Now, how are you going to put the blame on Punjab for this?
No, first of all, we are not blaming anybody. As I said, that it is the effort of everybody. And you saying that we have failed is also a wrong statement to make, that we have failed. We have, because of our efforts, there has been a reduction in pollution by 25% in the average PM2.5 levels. So saying that it is that we have completely failed is not a correct statement to be made, because if we had failed, there wouldn't have been a reduction in the pollution level. And we are not here to blame anybody. We are always saying that it has to be a combined effort of each and everybody, whosoever is holding any position, to help in getting pollution level down, because it is a fundamental right of the citizen.
Okay, so let me get in Harish Khurana. Harish Khurana, the Punjab government says the onus is on the BJP and the center to give us the funds to stop the stubble burning. We have the plan. We wrote the letter. The Aam Aadmi Party says that neighboring states of Haryana and Punjab have to stop stubble burning. The center has to stop the thermal plants. In fact, today I believe Mr. Satyendra Jain has written a letter to the center saying, please shut down the 11 thermal plants which are in and around our Delhi. We've done our bit inside Delhi, but what about those around us? So what's the center done in the last 1 year?
Tanvi, I still remember last year when we have a heated discussion on the same platform, and I promise you, next year when we sit down, we will see a lot of changes in terms of what the central government has done. Like, for example, I'll give you a short note on this. Last year, I promised you that the CND waste will be taken care of. So, proudly, I can say 11,000 metric ton now has been taken care of by NHAI. And this year, we'll be taking out 50,000 tons now. Also, if you talk about central level contribution, central government contribution, BS4 has been already been implemented by from April 2020. Also, we have implemented, you have seen a lot of underpasses and overbridges have been come on NHAI. So the carbon emission and emission has been come down. Now, I was listening to Aam Aadmi Party and Congress spokesperson. They are saying that Punjab, as Congress spokesperson said, that Punjab has done, don't have any funds on that. You have got your figures. I also have a figure of Haryana. Like Haryana last year has given 17,458 stubble burning machines. And this year they are already given 33,357 machines. So the problem with the central government and the state government today of the financial crisis is same. So when Haryana government can give, why can't Punjab government can't give? I'm not able to understand. As far as the Delhi government is concerned, on one day, odd day, they say stubble burning is a major cause. And even day, Aam Aadmi Party says because of the thermal power stations, this carbon problems comes in. I would like to ask from Aam Aadmi Party government, you have set up a committee from Washington University. Can you, which will give you a real time problem of pollution? Where is that report? 1.5 years back, you have said that report will be public, and you will be implementing those things. Well, where is that? So, if you see, if you point out one finger to other, you should see four fingers come to you also. So, I think we should understand the only stubble burning is not the cause. It's a joint vehicle applications, CND waste, and other things also causes of pollution in Delhi. So as far as CND is concerned, Central has already taken it, 11,000 metric ton last year, this year, 50,000 metric ton will be taken care of.
So okay, I will ask AAP and Congress to respond to that. But Mr. Khurana, I didn't understand, if there's so many machines have been given in Haryana and to the farmers, then why is the stubble burning gone up again this year?
See, as far as, because it's a major concern, I was listening to Raghav Chadda's statement other day. He only said that 10% of the stubble burning is coming from Haryana and 90% is coming from Punjab. And I think because you have also got the figure with you guys, if you want, I can give it to you also, share with you. Haryana government this year, already stubble burning has come down by 57% through last year. 57%. So already we are giving it and we are taking care of. It's Punjab government who has to see, because 90% of the, and you have also stated that this year is a whopping increase of three-fourths, more than 75% of the cases have been increased since last year. So Punjab government has to take the onus on this.
Okay, so then who wants to go first? Abhishek, that do you want to respond before I go to Captain Shalini Singh, and then we go back to our experts?
Yes, then we just couple of quick response. You know, I had filed an RTI with the Delhi government this year asking how many buses are required in Delhi and what is the current capacity of buses in Delhi and how many buses the Delhi government has purchased in the last 6 years. I'm sharing the RTI with you, which is filed by my own name. It very clearly says in the last 6 years, Delhi government has not purchased a single bus. And the total requirement of buses in Delhi is 11,000, out of which 5,500 was to be purchased by the Delhi government. And at the day today, they have only 3,700 buses. Where metro is concerned, for the first time in the history of metro, the metro has been badly delayed in phase 4 and phase 5. We must realize one thing, Tanvi, where specifically Delhi NCR is concerned, there is no public transport. And especially during this time, during Corona time, there's limitation in metro, there's limitation in buses. and the amount of people on roads, especially on two-wheelers, which is the highest reason for air pollution, the pressure in Delhi is so much that eventually crop burning along with vehicular movement, it adds on to more and more pollution. And I would like to further add on about the report with Mr. Harish Khurana had mentioned. Delhi government got into a tie-up with Washington University. By March 2020, they were supposed to finalize, and June 2020, this year, they were supposed to implement air pollution plan. See, the problem today that NCR, which includes from Punjab, Haryana, Delhi, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, what are we facing? Whether it is EPCA, whether it is GRAP, whether it is Delhi government or anyone, why are we only discussing about air pollution in this 15-20 days? Due to coronavirus, we survived 4 months because there was no movement. Everything was clean. But yes, there were problems. If they were timely addressed, we wouldn't have been fighting about this every year. At the same time, air pollution should be termed as a national public health emergency. Till the time you don't focus on that, we will be suffering on this for years to come.
Okay, Captain Chalani, go ahead, please respond to this, and then I go to my experts.
Yeah, so I will say that number of buses has been increased to encourage use of public transport. I am not sitting with figures, but I will definitely get back with the figures.
I've got an RTI in front of you. You can zoom and see it.
Contesting anything. I'm just saying that number of buses has increased, and I'll come back with figures because I'm not sitting with the figures.
It's a Delhi government data. It says
now zero. Okay, I'm saying we are the first. Delhi government is the first who has collaborated with Pusa Institute and made a biodecomposer for the stubble. So that stubble burning is discouraged, and farmers will be given it, being given it for free from next 2-3 days, so that they understand that how harmful stubble burning is. And this move has only been done for other states to understand that the problem in Delhi for stubble is not that much as it is from the neighboring states. And as I said in the past also, it is very important to understand that it is not about blaming any government. It is about coming together and fighting this pollution. It has to be a combined effort. Putting an RTI and saying that buses is not being increased, I will get back to the figure. But before that, Congress party also ruled Delhi for 15 years. What have you done? Please answer me that.
It was the greenest capital in the country. You talk about green cover, you talk about transportation, you talk about metro, you talk about flyovers, you talk about bridges, you talk about any subject.
Okay, you only speak. Let me speak. When you were speaking, I was not speaking. So let me give me a chance to speak, and I will definitely hear you out. But my point is, it's not that pollution started in Delhi just 6 years back, and Congress was very much available in Delhi, ruled Delhi for 15 years. So have you, sir, put any RTI for that also? Please show me how many buses have put. And also, sir, what measures have you taken? After your measures, have we not put in more efforts to bring the pollution down? So you are claiming that after Congress government, what Delhi government has done is to increase the pollution? So I will not agree to that. That is just a statement for you to make, because we have been continuously round the clock putting in efforts to bring the pollution down, and result of that, 25% pollution is down. It is not increased. So you can't say that we are not putting in efforts, nothing has been done. And it is not a day, it is not a problem which has started with Aam Aadmi Party or Delhi government. It has a problem which has been there for quite some time. And all, again, I said, the entire of North India, whichever government is there, they have to come together and fight it out. Let's not make it an issue of my government, your government, central government, state government. It is about the lives of each and every citizen of this country. So we have to be very responsible in putting up blame on each other.
Okay. You know, all the steps that are taken, claims that are made, or steps that are not taken, promises that are made and not followed, at the end of the day, it comes down to the results that we see. The results are that the Delhi is again witnessing a poor category level air, despite the fact that this was the lockdown year, where for months together, barely anybody got out. There was barely any vehicular permission. Even the industries had been shut down. We are still already in such bad state. that your graded action plan has to be kicked in starting tomorrow. And when we talk about all of these issues, it just comes back to the same conversation that we had last year and last to last year. Dr. Harshvardhan Puri had a point to make. Go ahead, Dr. Puri.
So I was listening to the statistical data given by all the governments. The Delhi government is blaming the Punjab government is blaming the Haryana government, Haryana is blaming the center and all those stuff. So please, please listen to me. If you want statistics, I can give you statistics which will open your eyes. 12 lakh people are dying directly because of air pollution every year in India. Everyone in Delhi is smoking 6 cigarettes per day if we correlate the PM2.5 level to the smoking level. So 6 per day, even a non-smoker is smoking. A child who is not even born is suffering from the menstrual air pollution because of the PM point on which crosses the placenta and goes into the blood placenta barrier and goes to the neonate. So I just want to tell these representatives of each party, this is not a political debate. Please stop doing this state-wise debate, this Delhi versus... 2 points I want to make, that it is not a problem of Delhi. If you see the WHO report, 10 most polluted cities in the world are from India. As an Indian perspective, Ghaziabad is the most polluted, then there is Lucknow and all those stuff. And Delhi also comes at around 5th or 6th level. So it is not a problem of Delhi, it's a countrywide problem. The other thing everybody has to understand, if we keep on passing the buck to the other state, other government, that Congress was in power for 15 years, what they did, AAP is in power. Please stop that. Our parents, everybody has his or her child there. They are suffering. Every fourth child in Delhi is having some kind of asthmatic problems. COPDs are increasing. Our elderly are suffering. Find a way, find a solution before we get it extinct. Please, somebody from, I think Congress was making a point, it's a national health emergency. Every year after year, on these debates, telling everybody that you have to die because of this air pollution, this climate change. Then they show the statistics, 10 million burns, the 30,000 machines are given. What's on the ground? Please sit together, come together for the public. Think about people. Just don't think about politics. It's politics. Everybody, you are breathing the same air I am breathing.
Correct.
The child is also breathing the same air which you are breathing. So everybody is getting affected. It's not you who is getting saved. It's not me who is getting saved. So make policies, make amendments.
You know, and I find this very odd.
Emergency. Make it
yes.
A national health emergency.
Yes, and Dr. Puri, I find
please.
This very odd.
Please.
It's not to Thank say you. That our VVIPs, that are sitting ministers, that our politicians or even our MLAs and MPs, they are breathing some other air. They're breathing the same air. You know, I fail to understand how those who are living in Delhi and even the state politicians and their families and their relatives who are in all of North India and in Delhi, how is it not impacting them for them to want to do something about it, to bring about a change? Why is it that it doesn't impact them to the point where they say, no, we must change this. We have to live in the city. It is our national capital.
Yes.
Sanjay Upadhyay, who do we blame? I mean, at the end of the day, we're just pointed in one direction or the other every time we ask the state or the central government about what's going on.
I think we have to first get out of this blame game syndrome. And I think I join hands with Dr. Harshvardhan. Who said that, you know, we are all breathing the same air, every party is breathing the same air. I think there are some tough decisions which we have not taken. And I think I just want to point out those tough decisions where we have court orders, but those decisions have not been taken. And I think we are just sort of scratching the surface in terms of solutions. You know, there are some big decisions like scrapping policy. How do you scrap old vehicles? There are capping policies which no government of the day has come out that how much is the, at the end of the day, how many vehicles will actually ply on the roads of Delhi and NCR. So the quality of fuel, the whole problem of pyrolysis, the whole problem of unregulated small scale industries which are polluting and totally not within the consent regime of this country. How do you really tackle institutional capacity? It's very easy to blame the government at the end of the day. But what exactly are we doing to strengthen the institutional capacity? Do we even know whether our DPCCs of the world, whether our state pollution control boards have requisite space, resources, or the expertise and the bandwidth to handle the problem? I mean, do we have our police system, which is supposed to be the implementing law and order support system, or the district magistrate's office, which is equipped with handling the implementation? So I think there's very little debate on institutional strengthening. And I think that is something very important. We haven't talked about strong monitoring mechanism. If you look at, let me give you a parity of the forest fires, for example, when you compare it with stubble burning, and we've just filed a case in the Supreme Court where we're arguing this point, that if forest fires can be detected through a satellite system and a geospatial technology, and we can send alerts and then get a complete system to be galvanized to handle that forest fire, why can't we do the same thing for stubble burning? And I think we need to put systems in place, irrespective of parties and politics. And I think that's where we are missing the point. Similarly, the citizens' role and responsibility, we never talk about it. You know, where is that easy system where a person, a common citizen like me and you, can actually complain or alert the system when they see a violation of a burning of, you know, a waste, for example? I don't think we have those systems in place. Let me just talk a little bit about the MSP, which whole the farmer debate is happening. You know, the Supreme Court said, or the courts have been saying, and the farmers have been saying, please give me 100 more rupees over and above the MSP so that I do not burn. Are we going to encourage perverse incentives in this country? And I think this is where we are losing the plot. Unless we really look into what are the input costs to stubble, why technology can help. I mean, there are n number of technologies which can help in reducing the cost and actually doing very well within the existing MSP. But today we are only talking about which party will give the MSP to which farmer and why they're not giving it. Everybody is actually raising their hand that we don't have the money. I don't know the details whether they have the money or not, but perverse incentives certainly is not the way forward. And I think this is where we need to take our decisions. For example, source apportionment. You know, we all talk about which particular source is actually polluting Delhi. But where is that intensive plan for each sources of pollution? And I think that's where we are missing the point. We don't have that centralized mechanism. We don't have that institutional coordination, which actually can look into various sources of pollution and have a very definitive plan and fixing responsibilities, which you very rightly said. Whose neck is actually on the altar? You know, we haven't really spoken much about that. And I think unless we do that, there are 102 non-attainment cities. Now I think the number has gone to 129. So it's not just Delhi. There are 129 cities reeling with this problem of air pollution.
Absolutely.
And we haven't really tackled that by taking tough decisions.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
And I think it's time now, and not just debates, but to take these decisions and actually implement.
So let me ask you this question. I'm completely with you on board, even to the extent of the responsibility that citizens have at their end and things that we need to also keep in mind and consciously do. I'm with you also on the point of, you know, this is not just being a problem of Delhi, but in many other cities, several other cities actually have worse pollution, once winter set in. But we end up talking a lot more about Delhi. I do concede that. But to your point about institutions being empowered and tough decisions being taken, who's going to do that, Mr. Upadhyay? It still boils down to the same thing. Who do I ask for these things to be done?
No, as I said earlier in my opening remarks, that unless you go and have a tough look at your Air Pollution Act itself, you know, the legislative frame has to give direction. You know, you can't be sitting on a 1981 vintage and talk about a 2020 problem unless you revisit your frame itself. And this is where our legislators and honorable legislators have to think through, irrespective of party lines. Because as you rightly said, we're all breathing the same air. So they have to empower these institutions. They have to allocate these resources and they have to optimize these resources. You know, in my understanding, there are no dearth of resources. The amount of fine that has been imposed by NGT itself can run half the air pollution program, if you count it. But are we really rolling out a program with those resources? Nobody knows how much resources are being put in to tackle which part of the source apportionment of air pollution. So I think it has to flow from the legislator, and then it has to unfold through an administrative mechanism and then actually be implemented on the ground, which has to be monitored back, and the loop has to be closed. Unless you close the loop of monitoring and giving a feedback, we are still going to debate and we'll keep debating.
Okay, I take your point completely. Very quickly, Harish Khurana wanted to make a point earlier. Go ahead, please.
See, Tanvi, the point is everybody knows, I mean, there are experts sitting over here. We all know what the actual problems are. And we also know what the solutions are. Like, we know in September, October, stubble burning is a major cause of pollution. We all know whole year, vehicle emissions are the major problems, in especially talking about Delhi. One of the major problems is this. We also know that CND is one of the major problems. At least when we say keep this government is not doing their work properly. Like, for example, I'll give you two small examples very shortly. Like, Delhi government has kept 115 crore this year for environment, but only 1% they have spent. This is not my data. This planning department own site has given the data. They only spent 1%. And secondly, last year, I also still remember when we were debating, Delhi government has promised 25% of the total vehicles in Delhi will be electrical. If you remember that, I'll give you data from their transport department. In 10 years, from 2011 till date, only 1872 vehicles of four-wheelers are of electric vehicles. So when Delhi government or any other government is not doing their work, and when we raise that question, this is not politics. At least we as citizens of Delhi, we can say that if this government is not doing their work properly.
No, it's not.
With the fact.
No, it's not. Neither is the central government. Neither is the central government when it comes down to a crackdown on emissions. Neither is the central government when it comes down to crackdown on other thermal plants around Delhi. When we've obviously pressurized the Delhi government to shut it inside. Or updating the technology being used in the over 1,500 brick kilns that we have. The Aam Aadmi Party has made promises. Their upgradation, even for the public transport, is moving at snail's pace. The electric buses are nowhere to be seen. And then there is the problem of stubble burning in Punjab and Haryana, Punjab being the bigger one there. If only, instead of pointing fingers at each other, we all did our own jobs. If only, instead of finding ways to politicize it and play politics and make the other person look bad or the other party look bad, we did our own jobs and ensured that what we could do at our end was actually fixed. Imagine how much better and cleaner our air would have been today. When I said 128 Supreme Court orders between 2015 and now, that was just one example. A lot, many more in the high courts, many more in the National Green Tribunal, and scathing observations and comments. But it doesn't matter who are elected representatives. That's the unfortunate part. And all of this comes at the cost of your health. Thank you to our panelists for joining us on this conversation. I'm sure we'll have many more as the pollution worsens and the winter season proceeds. Thank you for joining us tonight, though.